सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। ओम सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओम शांति शांति शांति। सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृग्यत्तु निर्मलं अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहं नमत्तोऽन्यदिति मे निश्चिता मतिः।
సెకండ్ చాప్టర్ వేర్ ద ఆక్షేప అండ్ సమాధానాన్ని విచ్ ఆర్ స్పెసిఫిక్ మీన్స్ ద ఆబ్జెక్షన్స్ అండ్ దేర్ ఆన్సర్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ స్పెసిఫిక్ రిలేటెడ్ టు ద అనుబంధ చతుష్టయం ఆర్ డిస్కస్ అండ్ ఇన్ దాట్ వీఆర్ ఇన్ ద టాపిక్ ఆఫ్ ప్రయోజన విషయక విశేష ఆక్షేప సమాధానాన్ని మీన్స్ ద ఆబ్జెక్షన్స్ అండ్ దేర్ ఆన్సర్స్ specific to the prayojanam and the prayojanam of this text is jnanena mokshaha. In there we saw there are two parts of this objection and their answers. In the first part, which we can call part 1, there is objection by the Purva Pakshi that jnanena na mokshaha means freedom is not there by knowledge. And then, after that, we saw the answer to that particular objection. And finally, the Siddhanti established that by knowledge alone, freedom is there. And then, the part 2, which we are seeing right now, is the second objection by the Purva Pakshi. And according to the Purva Pakshi, he has established that jnanena mokshaha is not there. And therefore he says that by karma there will be moksha. And for that, first of all he says that karma has to be done necessarily. Because moksha is not possible by jnana and moksha has to be there. Therefore by karma we will get. And then after that, in the next avartha, he explains in brief, what is karma? And he says that there are two types of karma, vihita karma and pratishiddha karma. The karma which are enjoined by the shastra and the karma which are prohibited by the shastra. And there, in that particular avartha, he makes the side note also that this udasina kriya cannot be technically called as karma. What is udasina kriya? Is any activity which is neither prescribed nor prohibited by the shastra, such as walking or doing something else. That
walking, going for a movie, etc. Alright.
All those activities which are not prescribed by the shastra but which is done, those are called udasina kriya and they are technically not called karma. And then in the 75th avartha, which we are currently seeing, first of all the Purva Pakshi shows what is vihita karma, and then he says,
we don't say what is karma, we don't say what are the types of karma. What is karma means you have to say action is chalanatmaka. So earlier also, what is karma is not. What are the types of karma? Similarly, what are the types of vihita karma? So when we akanksha is for prakara, then we don't say what.
So in the 75th avartha, Purva Bhakshi is showing what are the types of vihita karma? And there he says there are four types of vihita karma: nitya, regular obligatory duties, nimittika, occasional obligatory duties, kamya, desire based duties, and prayaschitta, expiatory duties or expiatory actions. And then after stating this four times, the Purva Pakshi explains each one of them one by one. In the order in he follows is, first he explains what is prayaschitta karma, then kamya karma, then naimittika karma, and then nitya karma. And regarding prayaschitta karma, the Purva Pakshi said that those karma which are prescribed by Shastra for the removal of some specific papam, that are called prayaschitta karma. And there he gives the example that if because of pramada a sannyasi gathers some wealth and by that he acquires some papam, then to remove that papam, having kept that wealth very far away, he does 3 days of upavasa. That would be termed as the prayaschitta karma for that particular papam. And here we saw that the Tippanikara is giving the definition of pramada. And in the Tippani it is said that forgetting about the karma which is necessarily to be done, that is called pramada, or not doing which is necessarily to be done even though there is a desire to do it, that is called pramada. So based on this we understand that either the forgetfulness is called pramada or the non-doing of the action to be necessarily done is called pramada.
Inadvertence. Because in Tamil, pramada means joy. Eh? Pramada means joy, no? Yeah. Tamil?
Wonderful.
Ah. In Sanskrit, pramada means inadvertence, carelessness. Ah. The opposite. Okay. Ah.
And we saw that in this particular example which is given, this both definition or either of the definition of pramada will not fit appropriately. So we added sarvatha ananushtheya karmanaha tatvena vismaranam. Tatvena means anushtheya tvena, means forgetting the karma which is not to be done has not to be done. And the other part of the definition will be satyam api anichayam anushthanam. Doing even though there is no desire to do that karma which is not to be done, that also is called pramada. And here in this example which is given of the sannyasi, the definition of this inadvertence with regard to or forgetting with regard to not doing with regard to or with regard to the karma which is not to be done as not to be done, that definition will be applied to. And after that the Granthakara gives or the Purva Paksha gives the definition of kamya karma. What is kamya karma? The karma which is prescribed by Shastra for getting some result, that is called kamya karma. And the example which the Granthakara gives is that by the person who is desirous of getting rain, this kariri yaga or some other yaga which are done are called kamya karma. Or by the person who is desirous of swarga, the Agnihotra, the karma are also called Kamya karma. And then, after that, the definition of Naimittika karma is given. In that definition, the Granthakara highlights three points. The first point is that with regard to the non-performance of which karma, the Pratyavaya is heard. And Pratyavaya means?
Pratyavaya. Pratyavaya.
So the Pratyavaya is heard. And that is the harmful consequence. So it means that when the karma is not done, then there will be some harmful consequence. This is the first point. The second point is, if the karma is done, then there is no punya and there is no papa. And the third point is, that which is not prescribed has to be done regularly, but is prescribed based on certain occasions. That particular karma is called Naimittika karma. In the example given is of this Shraddhadi karma, which are to be done on the occasion of solar eclipse or some other occasion. And also one more example is given by the Granthakara. And he says, getting up and welcoming, which is necessarily to be done on the arrival of certain types of Vruddha. Here Vruddha means seniors. And seniors in terms of what? Vayo Vruddha in terms of age. Jati Vruddha in terms of class. Ashrama Vruddha in terms of this ashrama, Brahmacharya ashram.
Stage of life.
In terms of stage of life. Then Vidya Vruddha in terms of learning. Then Dharma Vruddha in terms of following what the Shastra is saying. And then Jnana Vruddha in terms of knowledge. And here the Granthakara makes a point that here Vidya Vruddha refers to the person who has got Paroksha Jnana, and Jnana Vruddha refers to the person who has got Aparoksha Jnana. And one more point which he highlights is that in this list of the Vruddhas which are given, the later one is superior compared to the previous one. So thus this example of Naimittika karma was also given. And then the definition of Nitya Karma is given. And there also three points are highlighted. The first is the same, the first two are same as Naimittika Karma. Means on whose non-performance there is Pratyavaya. And on whose performance there is no Punya. And the third point is different from Naimittika Karma. This Nitya Karma is that which is prescribed necessarily and regularly to be done. That is called Nitya Karma. And the Granthakara gives the example like Sandhya Vandanam or this Nitya Agni Hotra. All these karmas are Nitya Karma. And then the Granthakara or the Purva Pakshi concludes that in this manner there are four types of Nitya Karma and one type of one Nishiddha Karma or Pratishiddha Karma. Thus, finally, there are five types of karmas.
So, this text, those who are coming first time, for them, we are studying the text called Vichara Sagara. Written originally in Hindi and translated in Sanskrit. Very rare text which is written in Hindi and translated into Sanskrit by one Swamiji here in South India only. And we are seeing the second chapter, and this text is dealing with the topics very exhaustively, not superficial. So one topic comes, then all related, I mean not all, but many related things will be dealt with. And one topic which is dealt with in two chapters is Anubandha Chatushtayam. Anubandha Chatushtayam is four introductory points. Vishaya, Prayojana, Adhikari, Sambandha. So, the subject matter, the qualification, the purpose and the connection. And now we are seeing these objections and the answers regarding Prayojana. Prayojana means the purpose of the text. The text is meant for freedom, moksha. And moksha by what? Dhanam. Jnanena moksha is the prayojanam, the purpose of this text. And regarding that, some objections are raised and answers are given. That is the topic we are seeing. And there are twofold objections, or the objections are raised in two stages. First one is, Purvapakshi says the moksha is not possible by jnanam, because jnanam will give moksha when bondage is unreal. Bondage will be unreal when it is superimposed, but superimposition of the bondage of panatma on atma is not possible, because required materials, required ingredients are not there. And second objection is that, or second stage of the objection is that, since jnanena moksha is not possible, therefore karmana moksha can be considered, and karmana moksha makes sense. And this particular argument that through karma one can get freedom is given based on ekabhavikavada. Ekabhavikavada means the view that in one janma itself one will get moksha. Jada janam ki jarurat nahi. Many births you don't require. One janma you will get moksha. Only thing what you have to do, you have to bring your karma balance zero. If you get zero balance of your punya papa, then you are free. What nice thing, no? Zero balance, free. As long as you have some karma in your account, punya is there or papa is there, you will be in samsara. So what you have to do, you bring, you make your balance sheet in a real sense, and in a actual form that it is showing zero balance. Otherwise, no, carry forward will be that deficit sometime. Our budget will be deficit budget. So 5%, 6%, like the budget. So deficit is there. Or sometimes surplus, very rarely. In election time they may show surplus budget, but generally not. So surplus is there, deficit is there, samsara continues. Zero balance you bring, you are free. That's what Purvapakshi is telling. That is called ekabhavikavada. So ekabhavikavada is getting freedom from samsara by bringing your karma account to zero. And for that he is giving a program. So like how your budget, you this much income should you generate, this much expense will happen. So similarly he is giving budget, moksha budget. So for moksha, what type of budget you should have? Planning, finance planning. Similarly karma planning. Karma planning is this. He said, first of all you understand what are the types of karma. Mainly there are two types of karma, vihita, prescribed, and Pratishiddha, prohibited. And vihita karma, four types. Nitya, Naimittika, Kamya, Prayashchitta, which you heard in the last class we have seen. And so, four types of vihita karma and one type of this Nishiddha karma. So, totally there are five types of karma from one angle. And out of these five types of karma, what are the karmas to be done and what are not to be done? That is being explained from the next avarta, next section. So 76 to 80 is mumukshuna anushteya karmanam nirupanam. Nirupanam is the description. The description of anushteya karmanam, of the actions to be done. Anushteya means to be done, karmanam actions. The description of the actions to be done by whom? Mumukshuna, the seeker of freedom. And here we have to specify एक भविकवादे इन एक भविकवादा इन द व्यू ऑफ वन बर्थ फ्रीडम व्हाट आर कर्मास टू बी डन एंड व्हाट आर द कर्मास टू बी ड्रॉप्ड दैट लिस्ट इज गिवन दैट डिस्क्रिप्शन इज गिवन व्हाट इज सेड हियर मुमुक्षुणा नित्य नैमित्तिक कर्माणि कर्तव्यानि The description was that vihita karma, prescribed karma are of four types. Out of them, four, nitya and naimittika to be done. Mumukshuna. Mumukshuna means by seeker of freedom through zero karma balance. We have to specify. Zero balance, zero karma balance seeker mumukshuna. By that mumukshu, who is seeking zero karma balance. By that person, what are the karmas to be done? Nitya naimittika karmas are to be done. And we have seen nitya karma means the karmas to be done regularly. Generally people translate nitya as a daily. It may not be daily. It is not necessary. Nitya in fact primarily nitya in Mimamsa nitya has got the sense of mandatory. But we can also say regularly. Some nitya karmas may not be daily. They are to be done regularly. Every Amavasya or every Purnima it is to be done, still it is called Nitya Karma. Because to be done and to be done regularly. So Nitya Naimittika Karmani Kartavyani, to be done. Achha, now description is given. So what is the title? The regular and occasional duties are to be done Mumukshuna by a seeker of freedom through एक भविक वादा और इन एक भविक वादा नाउ विल सी द डिस्क्रिप्शन मुमुक्षुणा काम्य निषिद्धानि कर्माणि सर्वथा न अनुष्ठेयानि इट सेज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू मेक ए नोट दैट मुमुक्षुणा बाय ए सीकर ऑफ फ्रीडम काम्य कर्म एंड निषिद्ध कर्म काम्य कर्म मीन्स द कर्मास टू बी डन फॉर फुलफिलिंग द मटेरियलिस्टिक डिजायर दे आर कॉल्ड काम्य कर्म Like going to heaven, having some Brahma Varchasam, having some wealth, they are called Kamya Karma. Avahanti Homa, Kamya Karma. So this Kamya Karma and Nishiddha Karma, prohibited karmas, are not to be done sarvatha, completely, na anushtheyani, are not to be done at all. Sarvatha is means in all aspects they are not to be done. Not by everybody. If it is not to be done by everybody, then Kamya Karma will not be prescribed by the Shastra. But for Mumukshu, this Kamya Karma should not be done. Material desire, materialistic activities or Veda prescribed karmas should not be done. Why? Sarvatha Nanushtayani. Those Kamya and Nishida not to be done. Why? Kamya Karmanam. Devadyuttama janma hetutvat. Because kamya karmas are the causes for the birth of the higher birth of deva etc. You can become deva, gandharva etc. You get higher yoni. If you do kamya karma, then you will have the higher planes of experience. It means your Bondage will continue. You will remain in the cycle of birth and death. Only thing, you will be traveling by higher class. Like person is sent to concentration camp, but higher class. So, he is still going there only. So, Devadi Uttama Janma Hetutva. And Nishiddhanam Karmanam Krumi Kita Sthavaradi Nicha Janma Hetutvacha. And Nishiddha Karma to be avoided. Prohibited actions like what? Suram na pide, pibet, one should not take alcohol. So, alcohol sami roj pite, to nahi peena chahiye. So, nishiddha karma, it is prohibited action. And why this prohibited action should not be done? Kya prashna hai? So, prohibited action not to be done because prohibited. But why prohibited action should not be done? He says, Nishiddhanam Karmanam, these prohibited actions are the cause, Hetutvat, are the cause for Nicha Janma, inferior life or inferior birth, such as Krumi. Krimi means we can say worms, kita, insect, sthavara, plants. So a person does the karmas which are prohibited in Shastra, like hurting some people, killing some people out of anger, etc., then this person will be sent to this type of birth. Krumi, Kita, Sthavara, this Nicha Janma. Alright. So Sthavara means plants. So they become plants. So somebody, I like to be a rose plant, etc. But you know, somebody will be trimming, they will do, that time pain will be there. So that time you cannot shout also. Pain will be there, shouting not possible, allowed. So it is painful. Therefore, sthavaradi nicha janma hetutva nishiddhanam karmanam nishiddhani karmani na anushteyani. Tasma, therefore, mumukshuhu tani kamya nishiddhani karmani varjayitva sada nityani anutishte. Therefore means since the kamya karma leads to higher janma and the nishiddha karma leads to lower janma, and mumukshu would not like to have higher or lower janma both, therefore mumukshu, the seeker of freedom, tani kamya nishiddhani karmani varjayitva, having avoided those desire based activities and the prohibited activities, sada, always, means regularly, nityani anutishthe, should perform the regular duties like Sandhya Vandanam, Agni Hotra, etc. Nowadays, Sandhya Vandanam, Agni Hotra is not that, so we just discount. At least do you puja, do some plant seva, or the Panchamaha Yagnas, Nityani Anutishthe. And Saticha Nimitte, and when there is occasion, Naimittikani Api, we have to supply Anutishthe. And when the occasion arises, like solar eclipse or lunar eclipse, just few days ago it was there. But they say in this area it was not visible, therefore not done. Otherwise, there are some vidhi, snanam has to be done, japa is to be done during grahana. So, nimitte cha sati, when the occasion arises of solar eclipse or lunar eclipse or any such occasion, like in the house there is a birth of a baby, so some karma is to be done. Jatyashti karma. So, jatyashti karma is not to be done every day, when only baby is born. So, that is called naimittika karma. So, anutishthe, saticha nimitte, when occasion is there, naimittaikani api, anutishthe, one should perform occasional duties. Okay. So, naimittikani is a dvitiya bahuvachanam, the karma of anutishthe. Acha, then he tells that why we have to do this nitya naimittika karma, he explains in another way. Anyatha, anyatha means if nitya naimittika karmas are not done, nitya naimittikananushthayi pratyaveyat, the non-performer of nitya karma and naimittika karma pratyaveyat means he will attain harmful effects, and pratyavayena, by that harmful invisible effect, tiryagadi nicha yonim cha praptuya, person would attain the lower birth such as animal, etc. There are also people, there's somebody we like. I like to be a dog, I like to be an elephant. One lady in Bangalore, she was telling somebody, I like to be an elephant, but in Guruvayur, Guruvayur elephant is there. I like to be a Guruvayur elephant. So, but generally it is considered to be inferior yoni. And you see how these elephants are tortured. So that's why it is inferior yoni. Praptuyat. Tasmat. Therefore, papa pariharaya, for the avoidance of papa, nitya naimittikani karmani avashya manushteyani eva. Therefore, for the avoidance of papa, this nitya, regular, naimittika, occasional karmani or activities or actions, avashyam, necessarily, anushteyani eva, should be definitely done. Necessarily should be done indeed. Eva we can translate in it. Then, nitya naimittika karmanam tad ananushthana prayukta pratyavaya parihareva phalam natu phalantaram asti. He says, Nitya Naimittika Karmanam Phalam, the result of this Nitya Karma and Naimittika Karma is what? Pratyavaya Parihara, avoidance of harmful effect, which is Prayukta, which is caused by Tad Ananushthanam, non-performance of Nitya Naimittika Karma. So, what is the result of Nitya Naimittika? Avoidance of harmful effect alone is the result. Natu phalantaram asti. There is no other result. Like you pay the income tax. What is the positive benefit? Avoidance of penalty, avoidance of punishment, that alone is the result. It is not that you pay the tax and therefore some gift will come to your house. A Deepavali gift from income tax department. It doesn't happen. It just you are spared from punishment from this income tax department. That alone is the phala. इतना सारा पैसा दिया कुछ देते ही नहीं पैसा देगा दैट इज दैट नो थिंग न तो फलांतरम अस्ति तस्माद देयरफॉर अवश्यम नेसेसरीली नित्य नैमित्तिक कर्माणि कुर्यादेव मुमुक्षुः देयरफॉर द सीकर ऑफ फ्रीडम शुड डेफिनेटली डू दिस नित्य कर्म एंड नैमित्तिक कर्म हियर द पॉइंट टू बी नोटेड इज दैट दिस इज द व्यू ऑफ पूर्वपक्षी Who says the Nitya Naimittika Karma should be done by Mumukshu? What does Vedanti say? Vedanti also says that. Nitya Naimittika Karma should be done by Sadhaka. Tasmada Sakta Satatam Karyam Karma Samachara. In the third chapter, Bhagavan says, Karyam Karma, to be done activity, Nitya Naimittika, you do it. But, the basis for prescription and the role of the karma, that is different. According to Vedanta, Nitya Naimittika karma are to be done for Chitta Shuddhi till Chitta Shuddhi has not come in critical measure, in sufficient measure. Till then it is required and it is only for Chitta Shuddhi. Whereas this Purvapakshi is saying what? That Nitya Naimittika Karma doesn't give any result, only avoidance of punishment is the result. That is not the approach of Vedanti. Vedanti says Nitya Naimittika Karma are to be done by Mumukshu, but for Chitta Shuddhi and till he or she gets Chitta Shuddhi. Purity of the mind. Chitta Shuddhi means purity of the mind. So Vedanti's approach is do Nitya Naimittika Karma as a Mumukshu. For Chitta Shuddhi, till Chitta Shuddhi. Whereas these people are saying, Nitya Naimittika Karma are to be done for avoidance of Pratyavaya. Their approach is a little bit negative. Like for avoiding the problem, just you do it. Whereas Vedanti says, no, for purity of the mind, these karmas are to be done. Alright. It is something like he said, I am giving the gift to this my spouse so that she will keep quiet. So that is not the correct approach. I am doing it to make her happy. That's the right approach, you know. Anyway, so our Vedanti has got positive approach. Yeah. Means right approach. I don't say positive, right approach. Next, what about prayashchitta karma? Mumukshu should do it or not? So Ekabhavikavadi, he says, Mumukshuna prayashchitta karma api anushteyam. By seeker of freedom through zero karma balance by that person also, prayashchitta karma, the expiatory duty, anushteyam to be done. Means prayashchitta karma, likewise, you know, prayashchitta karma is very simple one, it talks about Ganga snanam, Vishnu chanting, etc., namasmaranam. So prayashchitta karma. There are heavy prayashchitta karma also there. Ashwamedha yaga is also prayashchitta karma. But he talks about the lighter one, so it is good. So it is to be done. What are they? Yaha pramadat papam karma kadachis sakruta prasangat samacharet tad dosha pariharaya taduktam tadukta prayashittam tena anushteyam. Yaha pramadat papam karma acharet samacharet. If somebody does the wrong action, papa karma, he should avoid papa karma, already told. but still he does papa karma, samacharit. One who would do this wrong action, papa karma means wrong action. Papa generating action is called papa karma. When kadachit sometime sakruta prasang, kadachit sakruta prasangat means he is doing right action, but while doing right action, some papa he did. Sakruta prasangat means sakrut means once. So kadachit, so means here also it is that he is doing generally right thing alone, but while doing the right thing, something violation happens. By inadvertence, he is trying to follow this nitya naimittika karma alone, he is trying to avoid nishiddha karma. But still, once in a while, sakrut has got the meaning, once in a while. Once in a while, because of the pramada, carelessness, he is doing papa karma, then tad dosha pariharaya. Then for removing, for the removal of that dosha, that particular defects, born of this papa karma, tadukta prayashittam, the prayashitta which is told in that context, means whatever prayashitta prescribed for that karma, tena means by that seeker, anushteyam should be performed. Means once in a while it is bound to happen. Nobody can claim that Swamiji whole day, whole month, I have not done a single papa. Can anybody say that? Once in a while it happens. Nobody can have perfect life. So once in a while papa will happen. You may shout at somebody or you may kill some insect. All these are bound to happen. हमारा पाव हम बोले कि सर पे तो नहीं रख सकते हैं ना, सो वी कैनॉट कीप अवर फीट ऑन अवर हेड, सो वील बी वॉकिंग विद अवर फीट, सो वील बी स्टेपिंग ऑन दैट, देयरफॉर सम हिंसा विल हैपन. सो तदुक्त प्रायश्चित्तम तेन अनुष्ठेयम, इट शुड बी परफॉर्म बाय दैट पर्सन. नाउ फर्दर ही सेज, यह जन्मनि निषिद्धाचरणा संभवेपि जन्मांतरार्जित पाप परिहाराय साधारण प्रायश्चित्तम अवश्यम सर्वे ही अनुष्ठेयम. इन द प्रीवियस सेंटेंस स्पेसिफिक प्रायश्चित्तम वी टॉक्ड अबाउट, सम स्पेसिफिक थिंग यू हैव डन व्हिच इज नॉट टू बी डन, सपोज ब्रह्म हत्या इज डन और सम परिग्रह, सम गिफ्ट इज टेकन फ्रॉम द पर्सन हु फ्रॉम हुम वी शुड नॉट टेक द गिफ्ट, देन सम प्रायश्चित्त हैज टू बी डन. इन अघमर्षण सूक्त नारायण महानारायण उपनिषद दैट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ पापा he is talking about, he said if I have eaten extra, for eating extra there is a papam, so be careful. So small papam but is there, no extra we should not eat. Or we have taken the gift from a wrong person, or even drinking little more, what drinking they have not specified, panam only they have taken. So anything done excessively it causes papam, and for that some parihara is there. Or somebody said, no Swamiji, in this life I have not done any papa. Then for that he says, iha janmani, in this janma, nishiddha charana sambhavepi, even though there is impossibility of prohibited action, prohibited performance, somebody may think, it is a wrong claim, but somebody may say that, I don't do Swamiji any papa. वो तो यहाँ तक बोलते स्वामी जी स्वप्न में भी पाप नहीं करते, इन ड्रीम आल्सो आई डोंट डू पापा. ओके टू सच पीपल इट इज सेड, यह जन्मनि निषिद्धाचरणा संभवेपि, इवन दो देयर इज इम्पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ प्रोहिबिटेड एक्शन इन दिस लाइफ, जन्मांतरार्जित पाप परिहाराय, फॉर द अवॉइडेंस ऑफ द पापा विच आर एक्वायर्ड इन अदर जन्मास. सो इट इज लाइक यू नो सम पंडास, they say you have to do prayashchitta, but मैंने कुछ किया नहीं, बोला आपके पिताजी ने किया होगा. So you have to do, so जन्मांतरार्जिता पाप परिहाराय, for the avoidance of the papa acquired in the other birth, what साधारण प्रायश्चित्तम अवश्यम अनुष्ठेयम, general prayashchitam should necessarily be done by everybody. Because you cannot claim that. In this charma, perhaps you can claim. False claim, but still you can claim. Swamiji, I never do any papa karma. Still, Shastra says, no, you cannot get away from this prayashchitta. Then you have to do other type of prayashchitta. What is called? Sadharana prayashchitta. General prayashchitta. He is going to talk about it. There are two types of prayashchitta, sadharana and general. Like sadharana and vishesha. So general and specific. Good, I am happy you caught. So general and specific. Like antibiotics, no, there is a broad spectrum. And the specific antibiotics. So sadharana prayashchitta is a broad spectrum. Roj khailo. Bacteria aayega nahi. So that is general. And then other is specific. So that is said here. So for removing the papa acquired in the last janma, sadharana prayashchittam avashyam sarvehi, by everybody anushteyam. Who says? Eka bhavika vade. Sarvehi anushteyam. Okay, that is a saving grace, you know, he is saying, we are not saying. So, sarvehi anushteyam. But we also say that keep doing some karma which will remove the past papa. That we agree with them some extent. Okay. Prayashchittam cha dividham. There are two types of expiatory action. Sadharanam, asadharanam cha. General and specific. Asya, what is the, he gives a definition. What is asadharana? Specific prayashchitta. Like a specific antibiotics. So he says, prayashchitta karma is like antibiotic only. It removes the bacteria. Bacteria. Asya papasya idam prayashchittam. For this papa, this is the prayashchittam. Iti, in this manner, shastra vihitam. In this manner, it is prescribed in the shastra. That is yat shastra vihitam. That which is prescribed in this manner, that this karma is to be done for that removal of that papa. Like in shastra, they say, for Brahma Hatya, Ashwamedha Yaga is to be done. So, that Ashwamedha Yaga will be what? Asadharana Prayashchitta. For that Papa, that particular Prayashchitta. That is called Asadharana. And he will give the example. Yatha Purvokta Upavasadi. Just as the Upavasa etc. which was mentioned in the previous page. What is that? If a sannyasi earns money, does some business and earns money, then he has to throw away that money from which he cannot collect it back. Therefore, it is said duram apasya. He has to throw away in such a way that he will never be able to have access to that. So give it to somebody who will never give you back. So to that person you give. So giving away that money and 3 days he has to do upavasa. That will be what? Asadharana prashita. Why? Because it is meant for specific situation, specific papa. Therefore, it is called yatha purvokta upavasadi. That is asadharana prashita. And what is sadharanam? Sarva papa kshayaya. Paya kshaya is there, no? Papa. Ya is there, no? It should be pa. Ya is there, no?
Yeah.
Sarva papakshayaya shastra vihitam prayashchittam sadharanam. The prayashchitta prescribed in the scripture for the removal of all types of papa. Sometimes our parents used to give some general kada. That general that. So for every disease it will work. Means some bitter medicine, they said it will keep you healthy. So, it's a general antibiotics. So, that is what? Sadharana. Sarva papakshayaya shastra vihitam prayashchittam sadharanam. It is a general. So, prayashchitta expiatory action prescribed in the scripture for the removal of all papa is called sadharanam. He gives an example, nice example. Yatha, just as Gangadi punya tirtha snana. Taking bath in the holy place like Ganga, etc. Adipadena Kaveri, you can take what is called here, which river is it? Sarvini, what is that?
Sarvani.
So all river, Punya Tirtha. And Snanam, ईश्वर नामोच्चारण, चेंटिंग द नेम ऑफ द लॉर्ड इज अ सामान्य प्राशित, वट एवर पापा, जनरल एंटीबायोटिक्स, जनरल मेडिसिन. ड्यूरिंग कोविड देयर पीपल यूज्ड टू गिव नो सो मेनी डिफरेंट, वी यूज्ड टू हैव हियर आल्सो, वी यूज्ड टू हैव सम डिकॉक्शन, वी यूज्ड टू हैव समथिंग वाज देयर नो, काढ़ा. So that is general immunity boosting. So that is Namocharanam. Namocharanam is very easy, and also it is a broad spectrum. It has, it can remove all types of papa. But don't say, Swamiji, I did japa today, so my all papa is gone. That is not there. People sometimes in the shloka bole ki aapko, it is the exaggeration is so much. He says Rama, पूरा बोलने की जरूरत नहीं है, हाफ यू से रा देन आल्सो पापा विल गो, दैट इज लिटिल अर्थवादा. सो वी शुड नॉट टेक इट लिटरली. स्वामी मैं तो राम कितनी बार बोल दिया, सो आई डोंट हैव एनी पाप, दैट इज नॉट करेक्ट. यू हैव एवरी टाइम यू डू सम जनरल पापा, पापा इन जनरल विल बी डिस्ट्रॉयड. ओके, सो नामोच्चारण, दैट इज व्हाई भगवान हैज सेड इन भगवद गीता, यज्ञानाम जप यज्ञोस्मि. जप is relatively easy and having broad spectrum. Now its area of operation is very broad. Therefore, Namocharana. And Namocharana, Ishwara Namocharana, Panchaksharadi Japa. Ishwara Namocharana means you can say generally Rama, Shiva, Krishna, all this. And Panchaksharadi Japa, specific Panchaksharadi. Here Ishwara Namocharana can be taken as Rama, 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 or Krishna, 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 that is Namocharana. And Panchaksharadi Japa, Namah Shivaya, Ashtakshara Om Namo Narayanaya, Dvadashakshara Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, these are called the Panchaksharadi Japa. Upavasa, Upavasa means fasting, but not a Gujarati fasting. Gujarati fasting is very good. In fact, we enjoy more than the regular food. We look forward to have fasting. Because they make so many items on Ekadashi. So Ekadashi items are more tasty than so that type of upavasa is not considered to be this prashit. Generally, that also will give some result. We don't say, we don't want to feel, make Gujaratis feel bad about it. So it will give less result. But upavasa means fasting, where you take only water, or you take only fruits, etc. That is upavasa, and that is called sadharana prashitta. Evam shastrena eva dvividam api prashittam vihitam. In this manner, by shastra alone, two types of the prashittam expiatory action is prescribed. Tatracha iha janmani buddhi purvakruta papa pariharaya shastrokta asadharana prashittam karyam. Acha, now this Ekabhavikavadi is telling what is the approach of Mumukshu with regard to Prayashchitta Karma. He says, Tatracha, of these two, in that regard of these two, Dvividam Prayashchitta Tatra Madhye, Iha Janmani Buddhi Purva Kruta Papa Pariharaya Shastrokta Asadharana Prayashchittam Karya. Out of these two, Iha Janmani, in this life, बुद्धिपूर्वकृत पाप परिहाराय, फॉर द रिमूवल ऑफ द पाप विच इज डन डेलिबरेटली, शास्त्रोक्त असाधारण प्रायश्चित्तम कार्यम. द स्पेसिफिक प्रायश्चित्त प्रिस्क्राइब बाय द शास्त्र शुड बी डन. शास्त्र सेज फॉर इफ यू हैव डन दिस कर्म देन यू हैव टू डू दिस जपा, यू हैव डन दिस कर्म दिस दानम इज रिक्वायर्ड. So whatever Shastra specifically prescribed, some karma, that should be done. What about Samanya? Ya janmani janmantareva anushtitasya ajnatasya sarvasya papasya pariharartam Shastra vihita sadharana prayashittam anushteyam. And so this asadharana prayashittam should be done only when particular action happens by the person. And what about sadharana prayashchitta? He said, iha janmani, in this life, janmantareva, in other life, anushthitasya agnatasya sarvasya papasya. The all papa which is unknown and acquired in this janma or the previous janma for the parihararatham, for the removal of that papa, shastra vihita sadharana prayashittam. General expiatory action prescribed by the shastra should be done. Now he wants to say that what is the speciality of asadharana prayashitta? Asadharana prayashittasya hi ayam svabhavaha. Because this is the nature of the specific prayashitta. What is that? Yat papa nivruttaye yat prayashittatvena vihitam tena tat papam avashya nivartate tad bhinna papa nirharane tad asamartham iti. What is the asadharana prayashitta svabhava? Nature of the specific prayashitta is this. Yat papa nivruttaye, for the removal of which papa, yat, whatever action, prayashittatvena, as the expiatory action, vihitam, prescribed, tena, by that karma, tat papam, that papa, avashyam nivartate, is definitely removed. For example, for that sannyasi, doing the upvasa for 3 days, is prescribed for removing the papa of earning money. Then, when he does upavasa, that papa is removed, which was acquired due to doing commercial activities. Tat papam avashyam nivartate. But, tat bhinna papa nirharane tat asamartham. But that upavasa is incapable, asamartham. For what? Tat bhinna papa nirharane. For removing any papa other than that. When you take specific medicine, then it will remove specific disease only. It will not remove other disease. Somebody has got skin allergies, if you take the medicine for skin allergy will go away. Stomachache will not go. So he says specific will remove that particular papa for which it is prescribed. But this specific prayashitta is incapable in removing any papa other than that. Idam mittha beva iti janmantara anushthita papa parigdanat tan nivruttaye sadharana prayashitta beva anushthaya. He gives a nice suggestion. Idam mittha beva iti, this is like this for some karma. Idam ittham eva, this is like this. Iti, in this manner, janmantara anushthita papa aparigdana. Because of not having the knowledge, on account of being performed in other life, what type of knowledge you don't have? Idam ittham eva, this karma was done in this manner. And for this is the prashitta. This type of parigdhanam is not there. Means, we might have done so many types of papa karma which we do not. So, other day, in last janma, I went to this place and there I slapped somebody. So, that type of account we don't have. Slapped how many times? That I don't remember. So, how much papa collected? So, idam ittham eva. This is like this. This type of aparigdana. The knowledge is not there. Tan nivruttaye. Means for Agnata Papa Nivruttaye, for the removal of Agnata Papa, Sadharana Prayashitta Meva Anushtheyam. The general Prayashitta alone should be done. Because we do not know. So when we do not know what specific Papam is done, so what we have to do? General. Like doctor is not able to find out which type of infection, from which bacteria infection. So general de deta hai. He gives general antibiotics. Because whichever works, something will work. So similarly here, when you do not know that specific papa was done in a specific situation, then you do general prashitta. Alright. More we'll see in the next class. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnam Avashishyate. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Guru Namaha.